It is a wise and particularly relevant supposition that the media of communication available to a particular culture are a dominant influence on the formation of the culture's intellectual and social preoccupations. Television's effects are a direct result of the moments leading up to its invention and the concurrent response we had to it.
Keep young and beautiful. It's your duty to be beautiful. Keep young and beautiful. If you want to be loved, don't fail to do your stuff with a little pot and a puff. Keep young and beautiful. If you want to be loved.
I'd like to know why Penny's here.
I'm here to support my man, just like you.
What are you going to do? Take people's drink orders and get them wrong?
Do it.
According to Fatigue and Henderson, the role of the media is providing social context for the development of eating disorders. There is a perceived pressure to be thin that leads to body dissatisfaction.
What's cute about a little cutie? It's her beauty, not brains. Old Father Time will never harm you if your charm still remains. After you grow old, baby, you don't have to be a cold baby.
The lie here is the power of the woman's body. Though it may have some sway in what men will be willing to do for the ideas of attaining it, these images show women as being in absolute control as a result of their bodies.
Women who wear tight and revealing clothing are no longer deemed by society as slutty. Instead, they are seen as sexually free and in control of their sexuality. Television has cultivated within us desensitization to the sexual exploitation of women and the sexual allowance of men. Women start to feel negatively about their self-image if they are not sexual. And due to them being taught that they need to be sexualized, it is how they offer themselves to the world.
I didn't feel the fairy tale feeling. Oh, am I a stupid girl for even it's not like the